A big part of my career as a retoucher has been doing a ton of product retouching. Luxury goods, cars, tech. I've done thousands of images that are basically manufactured objects that I had to clean up. And one of the worst things about product retouching is edge cleanup, where like two areas of, you know, a phone meet or a shoe, and different materials really, especially in like apparel and shoes, they just don't really go together very well. And you have to clean that stuff up, and it can be just so painful to do. Years ago, I developed this technique to get around that. If you saw my first commercial tutorial, I taught it in that. Basically, what you do is use the pen tool to outline all the major shapes within your object and set your layers up in a way using these guides to make all of the edges come together in a perfect line without having to use the clone tool or doing any of that painful cleanup. It's a great workflow. I relied on it heavily to not go insane retouching thousands of shoes, but it was still really complicated to set up. You had to clip everything out. You still have to do that, but you had to build a whole complicated layer stack and all of these stencil guide layers before you could even jump into Liquify. Once you get into Liquify, cleaning up the edges of a product is virtually effortless. It's actually fun to do because you don't have to do all this little noodly work. You just sort of push all the edges out and you get perfect lines every time. I knew that I needed a better way to do that workflow because it was still taking me like 20, 30 minutes to set up. So I developed a tool called EdgeLab, which solves all of the painful steps of the process that can be reproduced. EdgeLab looks at all of the paths in your image and builds all of the tools you need automatically so you can go directly into Liquify and do the fun creative work. So you'll see in my document here, I've got in my paths, I've got the outline of this shoe. I've got each of the soles clipped out. Because if I zoom in here, you'll see what I mean by edge cleanup. This stuff. It's just the standard manufacturing defects that you know, are present in almost all mass-produced goods. And, you know, previously retouchers had to really, really painstakingly clean this stuff up through cloning. I, even now, as good as I am at retouching, I would really just get depressed if I had to clean this up with the clone tool or healing brush. I just don't want to even mess with that. So, for product retouchers, what we do is we create the lines we want, not the ones we have. So when I outline this bottom sole, I don't pay attention to where these like variations are, where it changes there. I know that my product needs to have totally smooth, clean lines that come together in a clean way. So I just create a really smooth contoured line for each of the edges where the different material panels come together. So how do we set it up? Let's go back into the layers. And open up EdgeLab. So the first thing you're going to notice when you open EdgeLab, if you have paths present in the document, EdgeLab is smart. It already goes looking for the paths. And if you have them in there, it's going to index your paths and list them here. If you create new paths in this document, you can always re-index by hitting the index button, and it'll add the new path or take it away. What EdgeLab is going to do is set up all of your guides for liquifying, all of your folders, and all of your masks. It totally eliminates a lot of time spent doing stuff that's repetitive and just really not that awesome. The other thing I included in EdgeLab is this mask feather setting, which if you set up a lot of masks and do product retouching, you probably know that you need to add a little bit of feather to the mask edge so the edges aren't too harsh. I usually crank it up to 0.5 to 1 pixel for average size product images. So you have to tell EdgeLab if you want to change what's called your silo. Silo is just a sort of shorthand for silhouette. And in this group, I always start by outlining the entire object first, and that's set to my silo layer. If you don't want to output all of your paths, you can turn ones off that you don't want to create any layer groups or guides for. So that's all you have to do to set this up. Click OK and watch all of your tools magically appear. Cool, so I'll turn the background layer back on. EdgeLab has set up your entire layer structure, turned all of your paths into masks, which is exactly what we want to see, nested all of your secondary paths inside your silo, named them all with the names that you have already created there, and duplicated whatever your base layer was inside each layer group, so that you have the pixel layer in there to liquify out. EdgeLab also creates all of the guides, both positive and negative versions of each guide, with corresponding colors in your EdgeLab guides folder. And I'm gonna show you how to use all of these in Liquify. It's really easy. So at this point, you can put EdgeLab back in the dock and get to work. So starting at the top, I'm going to run Liquify on this layer. Filter, Liquify. So Liquify takes you out of Photoshop for a minute. And that's why we created these guides. The guides are there for you to load into a very little known feature called Show Backdrop. You'll probably usually have this off unless you're using this particular workflow. So, what I'm going to do is be able to see what the edges are that I'm correcting in Liquify, even though I can't access my Photoshop document. That's where the guides come in. And I can find all of my guides right here. And they're named this way, plus and minus, because one is a positive, one's a negative. And so you can find them in this massive layer stack that Liquify indexes in case you have tons of layers in here. You can always spot these really easy. I'm going to move on to Soul 3 now, because that's the one with the biggest problems. So for this example, I'm just going to focus on this area here, because it's really just easy to see how bad that edge is. So you can go into Liquify with Control-Shift-X. And so I want to load Soul 3. Negative. And really quickly just clean up the interior edge of Soul 3. So, I mean, can you imagine cleaning this up with the clone tool? Compared to this, that just seems like absolute torture. And to finish cleaning this edge up, I'm going to go into the background layer, the base, and do one final Liquify pass using that Soul 3. Stencil guide. And check it out. This is a spot that's going to be super satisfying to clean up. Now you might be seeing a little bit of smudging, but overall, Liquify does this incredible job of maintaining the texture. It tries to preserve the detail of your smudges as best it can. It does a great job. Now, I mean, look at that. That would have taken me, I don't know how long. That would have taken me like 30 minutes, 45 minutes with a clone tool, and it would have been extra painful. Keep in mind too that this EdgeLab workflow and plugin is not just for product retouchers. Anytime you sit down to work on commercial imagery, the goal is just gonna be total perfection. And you know how time consuming that can be. EdgeLab is going to shave so many hours off your work. If you need to clean up the edges between materials, virtually any object that's manufactured is going to have that. So product retouchers, automotive, architectural, think about the inside of a building. You know, those edges aren't perfect either. And if you're selling, you know, products in a catalog for home goods, those images get heavily, heavily retouched. And they have to do the same thing, clean up edges with painstaking tools. And this is the reason I created this tool, was because I could not stand spending those countless hours doing that tedious, tedious manual labor. So these are really incredible cleanup results to get that quickly. It's really just a matter of setting up your file using the EdgeLab workflow, letting EdgeLab do all the work for you to create all the tools you need, and you can jump right in to Liquify and get amazing edge cleanup results in a fraction of the time that it takes to do it with traditional methods.